How would you describe your mood in 3 words? I'd probably use 2 words, not 3. What's the best part about being your job title? I guess they're talking about me as a teacher. I just like the freedom to explore ideas and work on, you know, interesting projects, see what's new in technology, and then share that with other people. It's a lot of fun. What are you currently reading? These questions. Which language is the best for an absolute beginner to learn? That's a tough one, but I would probably lean toward Python. It's pretty beginner friendly, but it really depends on what you want to do. That's the question you should ask first, is what do you want to build, and then figure out what language you need to use to do that. Android or iPhone, clearly iPhone. What are a few of your favorite tools and why? Well, you know, I don't really think about the tools. I really just think about the project at hand, because if you get obsessed with, you know, a hammer, then every problem is going to start looking like a nail. So I don't really worry about the tools that I use so much as just worrying about whether or not they get the job done. What would you do in life if money weren't an issue? I don't know. Hopefully help people. Who was your favorite teacher? Clearly me. What inspired you to learn to code? I don't know. I've always been fascinated by technology and the intersection with art. And so those two things have kind of been a parallel throughout my entire life. I've always played piano, been interested in traditional art. I did acting for a little while. And in parallel, I've always been interested in, you know, computer games or websites or what's new in tech. And so I think it's the intersection between those things that inspired me to learn how to program, because I really look at it as a means of creation. Who is the best band or musician in all of history? You know, I'm not really huge on music. That's probably weird to a lot of people because so many people are. What is your greatest challenge as your job title? I think my greatest challenge as a teacher is figuring out how to simplify complicated problems. And sometimes that just means that I have to articulate the complexity and say, this is a really hard thing, and it's just hard, and here's how, you know, we can make it easier and break down the steps. What are you looking forward to learning this year? I am hoping to learn more about machine learning. I think machine intelligence is going to be a huge component of the future, so I've been spending a lot of time on AWS and learning about IBM Watson and stuff like that. Where would you like to travel next? You know, I don't know. I'd really like to make my way over to Africa, just because that's one of the last continents I haven't been to. If you were to give yourself advice back when you were a kid, what would you say? Keep doing your thing. You're doing great. What web browser do you use? I use Google Chrome, but it's honestly for no particular reason. Really, Firefox or Safari or Opera are all good for their own reasons. So I think you should just use whatever browser you like best. Again, that really seems to be like a tooling question, which I like Chrome because I prefer their developer tools, but other browsers have great developer tools as well. What was the first time you encountered a real-world problem that you solved by building an application? So I was in college, and I noticed there were a bunch of flyer boards scattered all over campus, and they all had the same flyers everywhere. And I thought, you know, this should really be in a database. This was back in 2005. So I thought, well, I should put all of this into a database and make it accessible through a web application. And that way, instead of walking around this massive campus looking at the same flyers over and over again, you could sort them, you could search them, and actually find what you're looking for. This was before, you know, things like Craigslist really ended up taking off and dominating that market. But I built that, and it got a bunch of users, which is scary because it was probably horribly insecure code. And yeah, that was the first problem I attempted to solve. Mac or PC, I'm pretty agnostic there. I really like both for different reasons. Which accomplishment are you most proud of? Wow, I don't know. I guess, yeah, I've really enjoyed being a teacher here at Treehouse. I've been here for 7 years now, which, you know, I really enjoy doing. What do you think is going to be the most interesting development in technology in the next 5 years? I think the intersection of machine learning and augmented reality is going to be a really critical point for technology. I'm really interested to see what happens there, because if you can carry intelligence with you sort of beyond just looking stuff up on your phone, but actually interpreting the world around you for you, it's going to be some pretty powerful outcomes there. And what is a personal project that you're working on? I develop video games on my own. So I just released a video game on PlayStation, which is pretty exciting. What would you order for your last meal? Gosh, I don't know. Probably fried chicken, because I'm a vegetarian.